What's poppin', everyone? You got your coach of the Chim Chargers here today for week 12, our battle versus Data Dave, coach of the Kansas City Crocker Rocks. You already know it's the last week of WBE, which means that we have to cop the W. We just have to, you know, right before playoffs, you know, we gotta go in strong. So we have to cop this W here. His team that he brought here consists of Jirachi, Leavanny, Togekiss, Gudra, Ditto, and a Manaphy. So pretty cool team overall. Potential Stealth Rocker is going to be Jirachi. Sticky Webber is going to be Leavanny. He's brought Sticky Webs. He's brought the webs here with these six mons. So got to be careful. I already knew he'd bring the Jirachi Togekiss combination. The hack score is just too good. You know, you already know. He's got to use all the RNG to his advantage. He has to do what he has to do. This man is out here to beat me, to win versus me. So I got to be careful. He has the Manaphy as well, which is a pretty big threat with Tail Glow. Gudra is no slouch either. Gudra is a great mon. And then finally the Ditto, which is there so that I can't set up and sweep or anything versus him, because he can just send it out and sweep me right back. So our team, of course, is from the building video from yesterday, so be sure to check that out if you guys want to see what my team is. Link in the description below. I figured that he might just want to lead with either the Leavanny or the Jirachi is what I'm thinking he'll lead with, because Jirachi, you know, it can U-turn, it can give him some momentum if he thinks that I'll lead something to try to counter the Leavanny. But then if he leads Leavanny, you know, then he's gonna get up web. So I figured that my best lead was gonna be the Alolan Muk. The reason is because, number one, right, I can pursue trap Jirachi if he leads with it. If he leads with the goes for U-turn, I can literally just pursue trap it if I think that's the right play to do. Also, if he leads Leavanny, right, I can also have Muk out, go for knockoff or poison jab or whatnot, shadow sneak it right the following turn, or pursued it so that I can defog later on. And I think Alolan Muk is just great versus his team in general, because he doesn't really have a good knockoff switch. And I guess he has Togekiss, but if that thing is Choice Scarf and we get rid of the Choice Scarf, that means Cobalion outruns it, and it's going to be amazing for that. So I think our team's pretty good versus him. My goal going into this match was to try to ensure that I had an opening path for Diggersby. If I had Muk early on in the game, knock off items and get rid of mons that Diggersby would have trouble with when I lock into a move, you know, if I can do that, then Diggersby can really come through in the end. Similarly, Abomasnow can help me out a lot versus his team, because as you can see, his team is weak to the coverage moves I brought with Woodhammer, Ice Punch, and Earthquake and stuff. Team doesn't have a lot for it, so I just gotta be careful of the Ditto. Like, the Ditto is probably the scariest thing on his team, to be honest. Even above all the potential hacks that he has, you know, in my direction with his Jirachi and Togekiss and stuff. So let's just see how this match goes down. Like I said, I figured I'd lead with Muk here, predicting either Jirachi or Leavanny lead. So let's begin and see what happens in week 12 of the WBE. As you can see, he decides to challenge me, and this may or may not be his first mistake or my first mistake if he decides that he wants to flinch me down all the way. We'll find out right now. So he does lead Jirachi, which is what I expected. And anticipating him to go for a U-turn or switching out, I'm going to go for the pursuit here as he hard switches out. So I'm able to get off a clean pursuit and do a good amount of damage to that as he goes into Togekiss, probably expecting a knockoff there. So Togekiss comes in here, goes for the T-Wave, right? Turn two, I'm going to go right for the poison jab, as I know that he was probably going to either Air Slash or maybe T-Wave or something, and I get off a poison jab, which is going to be clean, doing some good damage. Now, I feel like he's just going to stay in an Air Slash here, but I want to test my chances out, see if I can break through or anything. He crits me, flinches me, I mean, as expected, you know, nothing out of the ordinary there, but I'm going to stay in here, just test my luck a little bit more. He goes for the Protect, so I'm thinking to myself, okay, Air Slash, Protect, and T-Wave. His last move could be Wish, perhaps, because like Wish Protect makes sense. Protect Roost doesn't make too much sense on this set, so he does, lo and behold, reveal the Wish here. So I'm like, okay, can I break through? And I do. So you know, he gets off the Wish, but I get off a Poison Jab here to knock it out. I think he should have just tried to keep Air Slash flinching me, but yeah, it's cool. We got rid of Togekiss, which is really nice overall. Goes into his Gudra. I'm gonna switch out here in fear of an Earthquake. As I bring in Clefable here to take any hit from this thing, he goes for the Fire Blast. So I take that decently well. Like, he still did some good damage, so I'm thinking he's probably max special attack or something. He's gonna switch out here into his Manaphy as I go for the T-Wave, just literally trying to cripple something, that anything that comes in, right? If he decides to stay in, I can get off a soft boil after that. I'm gonna pair the Manaphy and then switch out here to Abomasnow, expecting him to either go for a Tail Glow for setup or even a Rain Dance to try to get rid of the para. I'm scarfed, so I'm faster than Manaphy. and I do pack Woodhammer, so I can do a lot of damage. And he goes to the Skull, so I'm saying to myself in the battle, don't burn, please, don't burn, don't burn. And it burns me. So unfortunately, I got crit burned here, but it's all good because I do have Healing Wish Lottie in the back. So I'm actually just going to go out to that. A burned Abomasnow's Woodhammer probably won't be doing enough to Mana Fee to knock it out. So I'm just going to go into Lottie. As he goes for the Ice Beam, probably his next best move. I don't think it was a prediction. I think it was just him going for Ice Beam because it's neutral on Abomasnow. So I'm just going to go for the Mega Evolution here. And just go ahead and fire off a Psychic onto this Mana Fee. Just trying to get off as much damage as I can, because if I get low, then I can go for the Healing Wish back into Abomasnow and see what I can do there. But he gets parried here, and that doesn't do much damage. So I'm thinking to myself, like, either this thing is AV or he has to be like some kind of bulky Spidef set. So he does whip out the Rest here. He does reveal to have Rest. I'm like, Rest out of Rain. Pretty interesting. I wonder what he's going to do with this. And then his item pops, and he has the Chesto Berry. So he's Chesto Rest Manaphy. So that was pretty interesting to see. pretty interesting to see for sure. So I'm just gonna go for the Psychic, as I can go ahead and do a decent amount of damage to this thing. And he goes for the Ice Beam here. I know I can live and then go for the Healing Wish right after. Unfortunately, I do get crit, so not getting too fortunate right now, but it should be okay, because I'm just gonna go into Diggersby here. And I'm telling myself in the battle, I'm like, yeah, I'm just going to stay in and keep clicking attacks with Diggersby and just see how long I can do that for. He's gonna go to Leave Any here, and I can go for the return. If this thing was Focus Sash, I don't think he should have brought it in, but if it wasn't, then I guess it kind of makes sense. Maybe I was, it could have been maybe Scarfed, but I just decided to stay in here and knock it out either way. He goes now into his Ditto, which is gonna be probably Choice Scarfed, I guess. So he does transform into me, but I just decided I want to stay in either way. And I do win the speed tie if he is Scarfed, and if he's not Scarfed, then just faster anyways. And he goes for the U-turn, so I was glad that he didn't go for any kind of return or earthquake and whatnot. So then he goes here into Gudra. So I decided I'm just gonna stay in again, fire off another return, why not, and see if and just like test my luck here. And as you can see, I immaculately dodge a Draco Meteor. Diggersby just slid to the right a little bit, you know, dodge the Draco and knock out this Gudra. He's gonna go back into his Ditto here and go ahead and transform back into my Diggersby, right? And I'm just gonna go ahead, stay in again, go for the return. If this thing was Choice Scarf, I just won two speed ties in a row. But if not, then you already know Diggersby's out here putting in the work. Then he's bringing in his Manaphy, as I can just stay in here, go for the return again, and knock out the Manaphy, and get rid of that Pokemon. And finally, his last mon, which is gonna be the Jirachi, which is weakened too because of Muk's Pursuit. Thankfully, turn one Muk came through for Diggersby here to weaken the Jirachi. We can go for the return, and it's not gonna knock it out, but it's gonna be a 2-hit KO. He does go for the Iron Head, which is not enough to knock out my Diggersby. And I can go ahead here and knock out the Jirachi with the return and get rid of this Pokemon. And that is gonna be GG. It is Envy. Like I expected, you know, I was able to Pursuit Trap the Jirachi. I was looking at his team upon team preview, right? And I was like, okay. He didn't have to bring Mega Sableye, he didn't have to bring Chandelure, which means that Diggersby's return is looking really, really nice in the late game. All I gotta do is weaken that Jirachi. And in my team builder I was explaining too, I was like, I think that if Muk can actually Pursuit Trap any of his ghost types, or if I can get rid of Sableye or Chandelure, or even like Pursuit Trap the Jirachi, Diggersby kind of looks pretty clean. And as you can see, you know, it definitely put in the work, I think. So we got pretty lucky too. Like we dodged a Draco, and we got, if the Ditto was Choice Scarf, we won two speed ties. But I mean, the first one didn't matter because he went for U-turn, but second one, maybe if he was also Choice Scarf. But then again, at the same time, you know, he crit a lot of my mons, he burned my Abomasnow, crit my Lottie, crit my Muk and whatnot. So I think like, you know, I had to turn on the RNG generator, you know, at the very end, and you know, I had to activate my Haxing Self. So solid game overall, I guess. I think it was pretty cool. He brought some fun stuff, and be sure to check him out, of course. And I think I don't think he's uploaded since like week 2 of the WBE, but I think it's because, like, I talked to him about it. He said it was because of like some computer issue or something, and him not being able to record or upload or something. So I think he said he'll probably upload like towards the near future with all of his WBE games. So it should be fun to see. I'll definitely check those out. And that's gonna be it for me. Thank you everybody for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. Let me know what you guys think, of course. We end the season off 10-2 with a plus 34 differential, I think. So that's actually pretty good. Pretty solid overall, I would say. Definitely a solid season of the regular season. And you know, going into playoffs, I'm not sure who we face yet, but I'll probably have a better idea of that once I know what everybody else's score is and stuff. So that's gonna be it for me. So also I'm kind of out for the weekend, and I I'm out of town for the weekend, and I actually don't have the APA game until I get back, so I still have to play that. Actually didn't get a chance to do that, but that'll also go up soon, maybe like in a couple days from tomorrow when it usually is supposed to go up. But yeah, I'll get that game up soon, and you know, when I get back, it'll have some more Showdown Lives and whatnot. So yeah, that's gonna be it. I'll see you all on the next video, and peace.